A case brought against Total Energies by six French and Ugandan activist groups was today dismissed by a French court. In the suit, Total Energies is accused of not doing all it can to protect people and the environment in two projects, the Tilenga oil development and the East African crude oil pipeline. The campaigners had asked the court to order Total Energies to halt the East African projects in a landmark case based on a 2017 French law that makes big companies liable for risks to the environment and human rights. But the court dismissed the request, saying that only a judge examining the case more in depth could assess whether the accusations against Total Energies were founded and to then proceed to an audit of operations on ground. Environmentalists say plans by Total Energies to continue increasing production of fossil fuels such as oil and gas, which are key contributors to human-induced global warming, is at odds with what the company says it is doing. In Uganda, Total Energies E&P Uganda, a subsidiary of Total Energies SA, is leading the development activities towards oil production in the Tilenga Project Exploration Area 1 and Exploration Area 2 within the Albertine region. It is also playing a lead role in the construction of the EACOP, the world's longest electrically heated pipeline to transport about 230,000 barrels of oil every day via the Tanzania port of Tanga. In the downstream sector, the French firm, which has been present in Uganda since 1955 through its marketing operations, currently has over 200 filling stations nationwide. The EACOP and the upstream projects are, however, located in a traverse or take three. The EACOP and the upstream projects are, however, located in or traverse a particularly sensitive natural environment teeming with rare animal and plant life. But senior Total Energies officials have always sought to allay the fears of conservationists. We also spoke to some MPs on what this win means for Ugandan projects.
The courts have thrown out the case. It could be also because of the pressure through the lobbyists. There are so many. When you talk about business of oil and gas, this is about the world is powerful. Those companies, those multinationals that call the shots.
It is long overdue. We ought to have started reaping or investing heavily in this particular project. Oil is a resource that we are all looking up to in the development of our country. So those delays, those bureaucracies have hampered development in one way or another. So this success is something big that we should be celebrating about, and to encourage the Minister of Energy, to encourage the Chief Executive to fast track the investment in this project.